We are back with some Life is Strange, and we are about to meet Warren. So, let's
Max,
get on.
Get your ass over here.
Nice car.
Look at Warren in his Wayback Machine. He's a brave man.
Okay. Flash drive.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Okay, let's go with really.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Movie booty? I've been busy.
No, I've been way too busy with class and life.
Damn, girl, you had it like a year.
Or a week. I did browse through all the titles, drama queen.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
No fucking way.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Ooh, faster pussycat kill kill. I've watched that before.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right?
Oh shit.
You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal. Now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
I think calling the police would just cause more trouble, so I don't think I'm gonna do that.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Ah.
Hey, leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal, or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
The fuck?
Max? Chloe?
What?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! That's me! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beatdown for you.
Warren?
Yeah, I owe him big time. You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
I guess we are supposed to like Mr. Jefferson.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Damn. So she was the girl in the photo. Okay, that makes perfect sense, I guess. What's going on now? Aww.
Broken. Man, are you cereal?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Well then, I guess we're going to Chloe's house. Nice beat up truck with the American flag waving in the wind.
Come on, don't be shy.
America.
The house still looks
nice.
Home, shit, home.
Them posters. Everybody lies, no exceptions.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Music? Alrighty.
It won't play without any power.
I like how, as soon as I turn, there is a stereo. Wait, what? Power strip. Switch on. I remember when I was younger, I used to go out to a family member's out at the farm, and they had Christmas lights in their bedroom for a while. Ah, so many of these things, little things in this game, just, you know, kind of take me back a little. I love it. Okay.
Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days.
Wait. I'm supposed to turn it on! Let's search some more. Oh, pictures.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Hmm. Aw, the little white kitty.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Not much.
Not much. You know me. I like to observe the world more than participate.
I can't say I know you anymore. Maybe you love to go clubbing every night.
Can you see me at a rave?
I'd dose those candy-flipping morons and watch them twitch into a DJ dance death rattle. Take a photo of that.
Wow. Okay. I'll keep that as it is.
Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
Literally. Let's search in here.
Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
Huh. Okay, well. Where can we find...
Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair.
Where can we find some music?
This postcard is from Rachel Ember.
Oregon Coast. Huh. Miss you. Wish you were here. Okay.
We had such a blast drawing these together.
Wait, so she knows Rachel. Okay. Let's see.
I know my room is a disaster, but you can find a disc.
Okay.
I think this junk swallowed her discs.
Reminds me of my room. It's not that messy.
She looks super happy.
Oh, but she looks sad there. Doesn't look happy. Oh. Toke it up. Don't think it. Oh, what's this? She does know her.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Ember. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened?
Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
But how do you know?
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Damn. Okay. I was depressing. God.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
But you invited me over. Well, kind of had no choice, maybe. Okay, let's go at the door. Look around.
Whoa, dark. I cannot see anything.
There we go.
This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products. I hope Chloe isn't taking these pills.
Oh, damn. Let's hope not.
I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me.
I really like the art style of this game. It's really interesting and like spot on. It's really pretty. I like how I'm just, you know, making myself right at home. Okay, let's go downstairs.